Hey everyone, have you ever noticed that Christians don't seem to take responsibility for their own actions? Shalom, everybody, and welcome to Beit, Tefillah. For people firmly embedded in the religion of Christianity, it's extremely difficult to notice all the ways that the religion goes against the Word of God. And for those who leave behind the New Testament and its Messiah, it can still take a long time for them to see and process all that stuff that they once believed in. And this is normal, because there's so many lies to come away from, and it's hard to get your head wrapped around all of them. One of the bigger things to realize is that we don't have some kind of Messiah as our get-out-of-hell-free card. And not only is there no Messiah to save us, but there's no devil to tempt us. A lot more confusion is spared when you realize there's no such thing as going to some kind of hell either. Those are all Christian constructs. I'm sure most of you have heard someone say over the years that the devil tempted them to do something, or that possibly the demons tempted them and they couldn't resist all of that. But wow, what a cop-out. I guess that's easier for some than actually admitting that they thought something up themselves and then acted on it. It must feel better to just blame evil beings, I guess. And Christians also like to claim that Jesus or Yeshua is their righteousness, and they believe he made it so they don't have to keep that old law any longer. What they're really saying is, I can do whatever I want as long as I ask forgiveness for it, and Jesus is going to make it all better. So they either blame evil beings when they do something wrong, or let Jesus handle the problem when they do something wrong by believing that he's going to make everything right. Does that line up with what Elohim said? Listen to this verse, because this is God plainly telling us that we are responsible for our own actions. In Ezekiel 18:20, the being who sins shall die. The son shall not bear the crookedness of the father, nor the father bear the crookedness of the son. The righteousness of the righteous is upon himself, and the wrongness of the wrong is upon himself. Plainly, that's God telling us that we are responsible for our own actions. Christians and messianics, they need to stop the blame game, blaming the devil or his demons for their own bad choices, decisions, or actions. I made a video some years ago entitled, Are Demons Real? That explains a lot of this, and I'm going to add a link to that below in the description. I also did another one entitled, The Truth About Satan. And a good third video to watch is one that clears up a lot of this heaven and hell stuff, entitled, Eternal Life is Not Like the Christian Church Teaches, or Is Not Like the Church Teaches. I'm going to add a link to that below in the description as well. This video would be way too long to add all of that stuff to this video. So I'm just putting those there for reference for those who haven't seen them yet. Why are we told that Elohim flooded the earth? In Genesis 6:5, and Yehovah saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every inclination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Notice it doesn't say that demons tempted man nine ways to Sunday. No, it was mankind that was wicked. Wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every inclination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. The thoughts of his heart. Jeremiah 17:9, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? People's actions are either righteous or wicked by their own choosing. We're not being helped. It's in our hearts, and we alone are responsible. We have no one to blame but ourselves for our own actions. This is all very contrary to the Christian thought of people are born sinners. Without that, though, it would be hard to sell infant baptism, though, wouldn't it? We know that sin is breaking Elohim's Torah commands. How can an infant do that? They can't. But Christians don't really understand what sin is, and that's why they fall for all this stuff. They want you to believe that babies are born wicked, yet they don't have to keep God's law, which is the definition of wickedness, because Jesus supposedly died to remove their blame. But Elohim said nobody can die for our sin. The righteousness of the righteous or the wrongness of the wrong shall be upon them. And that's really straightforward. No Messiah can impute righteousness to anyone. That's nonsense and just a fairy tale. Job knew this as well, as we can read in Job 19:4. Even if I have truly erred, my error remains with me. And in Jeremiah 31:30, we're told, each one shall die for his own sin. Christians and messianics need to wake up and recognize that God is going to hold us accountable for our actions. He's not going to let some kind of devil be blamed for our bad choices, and he's not going to let some kind of Messiah make our bad choices go away or impute any kind of righteousness to us. And he clearly told us that. There's only one created being that can make you righteous. To find out who that is, go look in your mirror and read Deuteronomy 6:25. Well, that's all I have today for this short video. Thanks for joining us and for being a part of Beit Tefillah. A shout out and a shalom to all who are Yisrael and scattered worldwide in the dispersion. Everybody be blessed and have a wonderful day.